हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर मोहम्मद अहमद, आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू द 12th लेक्चर ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स 2. स्टूडेंट्स, इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर, दैट इज 11th लेक्चर, वी हैव स्टार्टेड यूनिट 2, विच इज डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर. राइट, इन डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर, इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशंस. दैट इज, फर्स्ट वी हैव सीन वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ ए डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन, एंड देन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड how many types of differential equations will be there, that is ordinary differential equations and partial differential equations. So as I told you, in this unit we will be discussing only ordinary differential equation. Not only in this unit, in the next unit also, that is third unit also, we will be discussing only ordinary differential equations. Partial differential equations are not there in your syllabus, right? Then after that we have discussed order of a differential equation. So what is the meaning of first order differential equation, that we have discussed, and what is the meaning of higher order differential equations also we have discussed. So as I told you that in this unit, that is in second unit, we will be discussing only first order differential equations, as the title of this unit is differential equations of first order. We will be discussing only first order differential equations in this unit, and then higher order differential equations in the next unit, coming unit, that is third unit, right? So after that we have seen what is the meaning of degree of a differential equation. What is the meaning of degree of a differential equation, that we have discussed in last class. Also after that we have seen what is the meaning of solution of a differential equation, and also discussed the types of solutions. What is the meaning of general solution and particular solution we have discussed. That general solution means if arbitrary constants, number of arbitrary constants is equal to order of differential equation, such a solution is called as a general solution, and if arbitrary constants in the solution are less than order of a differential equation, then such a solution is called as particular solution. So these things we have discussed in last class. And lastly, in last class we have also discussed formation of a differential equation. That I told you that how the differential equations can be formed from the given relation which is having few arbitrary constants, right? Some are, if a relation is given in between x and y, and two arbitrary constants are given, then how to form the differential equation from that relation. So for forming differential equation, what we have to do, we have to differentiate the given differential equation number of times, or differentiating number of times will depend on the arbitrary constants given in the relation. If two arbitrary constants are there, then we have to differentiate that relation two times, right, to form the differential equation. So what we have to do, actually we have to eliminate the arbitrary constants from the given relation to form the differential equation. So these things we have discussed so far in this unit in last class. And in today's class, students, we are going to see one important topic called exact differential equations, right? Actual syllabus starts from exact differential equations. So before that, whatever we are discussing, that is just the introduction of this unit, right? Actual syllabus, actual topics from which the questions will be asked in the examination starts from exact differential equation. But to understand exact differential equations, we need to see all these introductory concepts. Like before starting exact differential equation, here also we will see one introductory topic called variable separable method. For seeing variable separable method, now we will discuss what is the meaning of first order and first degree differential equation. Already we have discussed what is the meaning of order, what is the meaning of degree, already we have discussed. So what should be there in a first order differential equation? The highest order derivative should be 1, and in a first degree differential equation, the highest order derivative power should be 1, right? In first order means highest order should be 1, first degree means the power of highest order derivative should be 1. So most general first order and first degree differential equation will be of this form. So this is the most general first order and first degree differential equation. Right? This equation is the most general first order and first degree differential equation, which is very, very important. And throughout this unit, we will be discussing equations of this type only. So throughout this unit, we will be discussing equations, we will be solving equations of this type only, where one derivative, first order derivative will be there, dy by dx, and remaining all will be the functions of x and y, right? Whatever will be there in the equation, that will be of this form, function of x and y. So any given first order differential equation will be of this form, first order and first degree. What is the order here? See, dy by dx, it is the first order derivative present in the equation. It's a differential equation, obviously, because one derivative is there. And what is the order here? First order, because the highest order derivative present in the equation is dy by dx, which is first order derivative. So this equation is a first order differential equation. And also, what is the power of this derivative? Power of this derivative. So if we consider like this, power of the derivative is 1. So that's why this differential equation is a first order and first degree differential equation, right? So most general form of first order, first degree differential equation will be dy by dx equals to f of x comma y. Now let us see a few examples of this type. So equation will be of this form, dy by dx plus y equals to tan x, right? This is a first order differential equation. See, this equation can be written in this form, dy by dx equal to this y can be brought this side, tan x minus y. So whatever will be there in the right hand side, that will be the function of x and y. Left hand side, dy by dx will be there. So this equation is a first order and first degree differential equation. So let us consider few more examples. Second example is dy by dx equals to 1 plus x square by 1 plus y square. You can observe that this is also a first order and first degree differential equation. Right hand side, you can see that a function of x and y. So let us see the third example. X plus xy square plus 1 into dx plus y cube plus 3y plus x into dy equal to 0. Now this equation is also a first order and first degree differential equation. Why? This equation can be reduced to, now you just take this term to right hand side. So what will happen? Y cube plus 3y plus x into dx equal to, you take that to right hand side, then minus x plus xy square plus 1 into dx. Now take this dx this side, sorry, here it should be dy, no? This is dy. Now this can be written as dy by dx equal to, here minus should be there, then minus x plus xy square plus 1 by y cube plus 3y plus x. Now you observe that this equation is of the form dy by dx equals to f of x comma y. This equation is also a first order and first degree differential equation. So I want to say that first order and first degree differential equation may be of this form, right? So this, whatever may be the equation, if it can be written as dy by dx equals to f of x comma y, then that will be the first order and first degree differential equation, right? So equation derivative should be first order, derivative should be first order and first degree. Then the differential equation becomes first order and first degree differential equation, right? Because after studying second and third unit, we will be seeing many differential equations. So identification of equation is very, very important. So that's why I am giving the stress on how to identify the equation, right? This is a first order and first degree equation. One more example I am writing, dy by dx plus xy square equal to square root of 1 minus x square. This is also a first order and first degree differential equation. You can bring that you can bring this x, y square to right hand side, then what will remain in the left hand side, dy by dx will remain, and right hand side will be a function of x and y, right? This one and this one will make a function of x, y, which is of this form. So these are the few examples of first order and first degree differential equations. And remember that throughout this unit, second unit, we will be discussing equations which will be of first order and first degree. Now how to solve these equations? What is the meaning of solving? Finding the solution of this differential equation. Already, what is the meaning of solution, general solution, particular solution, all these things we have discussed in the previous class. So what is the meaning of solution? Solution is a relation between, it's a relation between x and y, and free from derivatives, free from derivatives. Derivatives will not be there, and satisfies the given differential equations. The equation satisfies given differential equation. So if such a thing, such a expression is called as solution, right? What it is? It's a relation between x and y, and derivatives will not be there. And if you put that in the differential equation, that will be satisfied. That will become an identity, right? So such a relation is called as solution. We have to find solution for every differential equation given in this unit, right? So various types of equations will be there. For solving all those equations, various methods are there, like exact differential equation, non-exact differential equation, linear differential equation, non-linear, Bernoulli, Riccati, Clairaut's, all these differential equations that we have to study in this unit. So before going to anything, I'd like to discuss one concept called variable separable method, one method called variable separable method, which will be used in solving most of the differential equations, and that will be applicable in most of the methods that we are going to discuss, right? Whether it may be exact differential equation, non-exact differential equation, it may be Clairaut's, it may be Riccati, it may be Bernoulli. So in most of the differential equations, somewhere in solving the problems, we have to use a method called variable separable method. So before starting anything, we will discuss what is the meaning of variable separable method. Remember that it's a method of solving first order and first degree differential equations, right? It is a method of solving first order and first degree differential equations. So we will discuss now a variable separable method. By the name itself, you can understand that what is this method. So variable separable method means what we are going to do. Basically, we are going to separate the variables. That's why this method is called as variable separable method. So what will be given? This method is used for solving what type of equations? First order and first degree differential equations. First order and first degree differential equations will be of this form. Suppose this is given. Given dy by dx equals to some function of x and y is given to you. Suppose if I am able to write this equation in this form, g of y dy equal to h of x dx. If I am able to write the given differential equation dy by dx equal to f of x comma y in this form, that is a function of y into dy equal to a function of x into dx, right? If I am able to write the given differential equation in this form, see, I have separated the variables y one side, right, and x one side. If I am able to do like this, means I am able to separate the variables of y one side and x one side, then solving means we have to find the general solution everywhere in the given differential equation. In each problem, we have to find the general solution. That is called as solve, right? So what is the meaning of general solution? Already we have discussed in the previous class. General solution means it's a solution in which the number of arbitrary constants will be equal to order of the differential equation. Here the given differential equation is of first order. So whatever the general solution we are going to find, that should contain at least one arbitrary constant, right? That should contain one arbitrary constant, then that is called as general solution. So here then general solution is given by, right, so integrate this, we have to integrate this. What we'll get here? Integral g of y dy equal to integral h of x dx plus c. So this will be the solution, general solution for this differential equation when we are able to separate the variables, when we are able to write y variables one side and x variables one side, then the general solution of the given first order first degree differential equation will be like this. We have to integrate both sides, one arbitrary constant will be there because of integration, right? This will be the general solution. So this is called as variable separable method, right? You have to remember this throughout this unit, because many places we will be using this variable separable method, right? Then after that, we are having a list of formulae. For list of formulae, you can visit my blog, in which I have given the list of formulae for differentiation and integration that will be used throughout this unit. Already you have discussed, you have studied this formula in intermediate, how to find the derivative of uv, how to find the derivative of u by v. So, and also what is the differentiation of what is the differentiation of a constant, what is the differentiation of x power n, what is the differentiation of e power x, what is the differentiation of sine x, cos x, tan x, cot x, what is the differentiation of sine inverse x. So all these basic formulae that we have that you have studied in intermediate, already that we have discussed in our bridge course for engineering mathematics, also we have discussed these formulae in mathematics 1, right? And this list can be found in my blog, right? You can visit my blog. There will be a link for differentiation formulae, separate link will be there. For integration formulae, separate link will be there. You have to by heart that, we have to practice that formulae, because many places in this unit and the next unit we will be using derivative, differentiation and integration formulae. And integration formulae, integration of a constant, integration of x power n, integration of e power x, and what is the integration of sine x, what is the integration of 1 by x, what is the integration of cos x, tan x, cot x, secant x, all these formulae we have studied already in the bridge course for engineering mathematics and mathematics 1. Also you have studied these formulae in intermediate, right? And the list can be found in my blog. So you have to go through the formulae. Now we will see few problems related to this variable separable method, right? How to solve the problems by applying this variable separable method, that we are going to discuss now. So problems now. So first problem is solve what is the given question? E power x plus 1 into y dy equals to e power x into y plus 1 dx, right? So this is a first order, first degree equation, because this can be written as dy by dx can be brought here. Dy by dx equal to e power x into y plus 1, and the rest of the things can be brought to right hand side. So this equation will be of the form dy by dx equals to f of x comma y. This is a first order and first degree differential equation. Now can we apply a variable separable method to solve this differential equation? Can we apply here? Yes, we can apply, because we can separate the variables, y variables one side and x variables one side we can do. So just you take this e power x plus 1 to right hand side and bring this y plus 1 to left hand side. What will happen? So y by y plus 1 into dy equal to e power x by e power x plus 1 into dx, right? What I have done? From the given equation, I have taken y plus 1 to left hand side, which comes in the denominator, and e power x plus 1 to right hand side, that comes in the denominator. So this is, what I have done here, I have separated the variables, all the y variables in left hand side and all the x variables in the right hand side. So if I am able to do like this, then the general solution will be given by integrations of this, right? Therefore, general solution. Consider the given equation as one. General solution of one is, how it is given? Integral y by y plus 1 dy equal to integral e power x by e power x plus 1 dx plus constant, right? This will be the general solution. So what we have to do now, we have to integrate this. We have to integrate y by y plus 1. Also we have to integrate e power x by e power x plus 1. Here with respect to y we have to integrate, here with respect to x we have to integrate. So how to integrate this? So all the techniques that I am using here for integration, you have discussed, you have learned in intermediate. Also all these techniques I have taught you in the bridge course for engineering mathematics. So if you are weak, if you feel that I am weak in differentiation and integration, then you have to go through the bridge course for engineering mathematics, right? 13 lectures are there. You just find out the lectures which are related to, I think three lectures are related to differentiation and three lectures are related to integration. If you feel that you are weak in differentiation and integration, then 100% you have to go through, you have to practice those lectures, you have to watch those lectures, and you have to practice the problems that are discussed in the bridge course for engineering mathematics. You have to watch 5 to 6 lectures. I request you to watch it, because in these two units, in these two units, that is unit 2 and unit 3, we will be using differentiation and integration like anything. Everywhere you can find differentiation and integration. In every problem, we have to do differentiation and integration. You need to be thorough with differentiation and integration. I request you to watch those 3 to 4 videos, because you need to get yourself perfect. You need to get yourself practiced in that differentiation and integration. See how to integrate this now. For integrating this, what I'll do here is I'll add 1 and subtract 1. Equal to here this can be kept as it is, e power x plus 1 dx plus c. Now this can be written as, see, this y plus 1, this y plus 1 in the numerator, I'll separate this y plus 1 by y plus 1, then minus 1 by y plus 1. So what will happen here? Integral y plus 1 by y plus 1 is nothing but 1 dy minus integral 1 by y plus 1 dy equal to integral e power x by e power x plus 1 dx plus c. Now I can integrate this. Integration of 1 with respect to y is y, and integration of 1 by y plus 1 with respect to y is log of y plus 1. Then for integrating this, I am going to use this formula. The formula is integral f dash of x by f of x dx equal to log f of x, right? So if the given integral is of this form, integral denominator f of x should be there, and the numerator derivative of f of x should be there, then the integral will be log f of x, right? The same thing you can observe here. In the denominator, f of x is e power x plus 1. Then derivative of e power x plus 1, derivative of e power x is e power x, derivative of 1 is 0. So it is in the form of f dash of x by f of x. So what will happen? Now integrate this. Integration will be y here. Then the next term, plus c, right? So log of y plus 1. Integration of 1 by y plus 1 is log of y plus 1. Then integration of e power x by e power x plus 1, according to this formula, it will be log of e power x plus 1. Now it's just a constant. C is a constant. I can write this c as, instead of writing c, I'll write this as log c. Doesn't matter, it's a constant only. Log c here, also log c, and here also log c, right? So what I can do here, y equal to, I will bring this log y plus 1 to right hand side. So log, what I'll get here, log a plus log b plus log c form. So it is log abc, log y plus 1 and e power x plus 1 into c, right? This will be the general solution of given differential equation. So this is how we apply variable separable method. Right, so integration is very, very important here. What I have done, I have separated the variables, y variables one side, x variables one side, then I have taken the general solution will be given by integration, right? So I have applied the formula for integration, right? Now let us see the second problem. The second problem is, solve dy by dx plus square root of 1 plus y square divided by square root of 1 plus x square equal to 0. Consider this as equation 1. This is also a first order and first degree differential equation. It can be written as dy by dx. Solution, it can be written as dy by dx equal to minus of square root of 1 plus y square by square root of 1 plus x square. So this is in the form of dy by dx equals to f of x comma y. Dy by dx equals to f of x comma y, right? So it's a first order and first degree differential equation. Now can we separate the variables here? Yes, we can separate the variables. How can we write this? So dy by square root of 1 plus y square equal to minus dx by square root of 1 plus x square. So what I have done here, I have taken this square root of 1 plus y square to this side and dx to this side. So I got this relation. You can observe that all the y variables are one side and all the x variables are another side. Then general solution of 1, therefore general solution, GS means general solution of 1 is, what I have to do here, I have to do the integration 1 by square root of 1 plus y square dy equal to minus integration 1 by square root of 1 plus x square into dx, right? So already we have studied one formula in intermediate, plus constant will be there here according to the general solution, right? What is the formula? Integral 1 by square root of 1 plus x square dx. The formula for this is sin h inverse x, right? So here what I'll get according to this formula I'll get here sin h inverse y equal to, here I'll get sin h inverse x plus c. Further, this can be written as sin h minus will be there, no? This minus will be there. Minus sin h inverse can be taken into left hand side, then sin h inverse x plus sin h inverse y equal to c. Right? This is the required general solution for the given differential equation. So this is how we apply variable separable method. Right? Now we are going to see, your actual syllabus starts here. Now we are going to see exact differential equation, right? Okay, the next topic is exact differential equation. Your actual syllabus starts from this topic only. So previously whatever we have discussed, from that no question will be asked in the examination, but the basics are important for understanding what is the meaning of exact differential equation, right? This topic is important for 2 marks, right? One SAQ question will be asked in the examination. 99% questions have been asked from this, and the position of question will be, see, for this unit 2, third and fourth SAQs will be there from unit 2. So either it may be third or fourth, generally it will be third. Third question will be asked from exact differential equation. So it is a first order, first degree equation of the form, a first degree, first order equation of this form, m of xy dx plus n of xy dy equal to 0. It's a first order, first degree differential equation, because dy by dx is there, first order derivative, and dy by dx power will be, actually this can be written as, so in short if I write this, this can be written as mdx plus ndy equal to 0. So this can be written as ndx equal to minus mdx, right? Ndy equals to minus mdx. Now this can be written as dy by dx equal to minus m by n, right? So this m by n is a function of x and y. So this equation will be of the form dy by dx equals to a function of x comma y, right? It's a first order and first degree differential equation, right? So any equation of this form, m dx plus n dy, where m and n are functions of x and y, any equation of this form, any differential equation of this form which satisfies this condition. What is the condition? Dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. If this condition is satisfied, right, if this condition is satisfied for any given differential equation of the form mdx plus ndy, m of x comma y means m is a function of x and y and n is a function of x and y, any differential equation which satisfies this this condition, that is partial derivative of m with respect to y if you find, and partial derivative of n with respect to x if you find, they are equal. If they are equal, for any given differential equation of the form mdx plus ndy equals to 0, if this condition is satisfied, dou m by dou y equals to dou n by dou x, then such an equation is called as, then this equation is called as exact differential equation. This equation is called as exact differential equation. Right? When do we say that? Given equation mdx plus ndy equals to 0 is an exact differential equation if this condition dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x, this condition is satisfied, then we say that the given differential equation is an exact differential equation. Now what will be the general solution of exact differential equation? Then if the given differential equation is exact, then general solution of, you consider this as 1, then general solution of 1 is, it is given by integral mdx, right, plus here y will be constant, in this integration y is constant, right, integral mdx y constant, then integral terms of n not involving x, terms of n not involving x dy equals to constant, right, this will be the general solution. This will be the general solution of, this will be the general solution of exact differential equation. Remember this, right? So what is the exact differential equation? Exact differential equation will be of this form, mdx plus ndy equals to 0, and for this equation this should be true, dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x, then we say that the given differential equation is an exact differential equation, and if it is exact, then the general solution is given by integral, we have to write m here, right, and integrate this m with respect to x, treating y as constant, that is the first term of general solution. And in the second term, what we have to do, from n is a function of x and y, wherever, suppose it, if it is having two terms, in which in one term x is there and in one term y is x is not there, so we have to write here only the terms of n not involving x, we have to write only the terms of n not involving x here, and integrate this with respect to y, right, here integration of m with respect to x, treating y as constant, and here terms of, we have to write terms of n not involving x here and integrate this with respect to y, right, equal to constant. This will be the general solution of exact differential equation. Now we will see problems related to this. Okay, the first question is, solve x square minus 4xy minus 2y square dx plus y square minus 4xy minus 2x square dy equals to 0. So this equation is a first order, first degree differential equation, which is of the form mdx plus ndy equals to 0. You can observe that this is m here. So compare, you consider this as equation 1. Compare 1 with mdx plus ndy equal to 0, then what we will get, m equals to x square minus 4xy minus 2y square, and n equals to, we will get y square minus 4xy minus 2x square. Now find dou m by dou y, dou n by dou x, check whether they are equal or not. So find dou m by dou y, it's a partial derivative of m with respect to y. See, when we are differentiating m with respect to y partially, x will be treated as constant. So x square is a constant. Derivative of x square will be 0 minus 4x is constant as it is. Then derivative of y is 1. Then minus 2 into y square derivative is 2y. So what we'll get here? Minus 4x minus 4y. Right? This is dou m by dou y. Now find dou n by dou x. Now find dou n by dou x. So partial derivative of n with respect to x. When we are differentiating partially with respect to x, y will be treated as constant. So derivative of y square will be 0 because it's a constant. then minus 4y is constant as it is, and derivative of x is 1, minus 2 as it is, derivative of x square is 2x. So simplify this, what we will get here, minus 4y minus 4x. You observe that dou m by dou y is minus 4x minus 4y, and dou n by dou x is minus 4y minus 4x. So the meaning is, therefore, what we can say here, therefore, dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x, right? Dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Therefore, what we can say, therefore, given equation 1 is an exact differential equation, right? Given equation 1 is exact. Now we have to find the general solution. Therefore, general solution of 1 is given by, therefore, general solution of 1 is, already we know the formula for finding the general solution. It is given by integral y constant m dx plus integral, here terms of n not involving x. Into dy, right, terms of n not involving x into dy equals to constant. This will be the general solution. Now what we will get here, therefore, what we will get here, integral y constant m, what is m from the question, from here m is here x square minus 4xy minus 2y square into dx plus integral, here we have to write terms of n not involving x. You see n is here, so it is having three terms, out of that which are not having x, this y square is not having x, here x is there, here x is there, this both the terms are having x, but this term, this y square is not having x. So here terms of n not involving x means y square. We have to write here the terms which are not involving x, which is y square equal to c. Now we have to integrate this. We have to integrate this to get the solution. See, first is integration with respect to x, y is treated as constant. Integration of x square. Integration of x square is x cube by 3 minus 4y will be constant, and here x is there. Integration of x is x square by 2 minus 2y square, 1 will be there. Integration of 1 is x, right? Plus integration of y square with respect to y is y cube by 3 equal to c, right? So further this can be written as x cube by 3 plus y cube by 3. See here what we will get, this 2, and here we will get 2. So minus 2 x square y minus 2 x y square equal to constant. So this is the required general solution for the given differential equation, right? This is the required general solution. It is having one arbitrary constant, so it's a, it is the solution of, it is the general solution of first order first degree differential equation given in the question, which is of the form mdx plus ndy, right? What we have to do, every time compare the given differential equation with mdx plus ndy equal to 0, then find out what is m and what is n. Be careful here, sometimes here dy will be given, first term will be this, you should not get confused. See, m is the coefficient of dx and n is the coefficient of dy, right? Whatever the coefficient of dx is there, that is m. Whatever the coefficient of dy is there, that is n. So find m and n, then find dou m by dou y, dou n by dou x, then check whether they are equal or not. If they are equal, then the given equation is said to be exact differential equation, and the solution will be given by integral m dx y constant plus integral terms of n not involving x dy equals to constant. This is the method, right? This is the procedure to solve exact differential equations. Let us consider one more problem here. The second one, solve x e power xy plus 2y into dy by dx plus y into e power xy equal to 0, right? This is the given differential equation. It is also a first order first degree differential equation. Can we write this in the form of mdx plus ndy? Yes, we can write. You just multiply this equation with dx, then what will happen, this equation will become, so consider this equation as 1 then what will happen? X into e power xy plus 2y into dy, dx will get cancelled and here we'll get dx equal to 0. Now this is in the form mdx, so compare it with mdx plus ndy equal to 0. Now this, so this equation is in the form of mdx plus ndy, we are comparing, then we will get m and n. You see that mdx, m is the coefficient of dx, so dx coefficient here is y into e power xy. So m is, we should not write that m is this and n is this, we should be careful and write m is this one and n is this bracket. So m is y into e power xy and n is x into e power xy plus 2y, right? Then find dou m by dou y. So while finding dou m by dou y, here y is there, here y is there. So uv rule we have to apply, right? We have to apply uv rule. So u as it is, y as it is, derivative of e power xy with respect to y. It is e power xy into, with respect to y we are differentiating, no? So power derivative, what is the derivative of this power with respect to y? Derivative of x is constant as it is, derivative of y is 1. So we'll get x here plus, and see e power xy as it is now. Derivative of y with respect to y, derivative of y with respect to y is 1, right? So what I have done here, I have applied uv rule. See this carefully, consider this as u and this as v. So u I am keeping as it is, derivative of v, derivative of e power xy with respect to y, derivative of e power xy with respect to y, it is in the form of e power ax derivative of this. So what we'll get here, e power ax into a, right? But here we are having y, so here y is there, so better to write this in this form. So it is in the form of e power ay with respect to y, e power ay, see this e power a, in place of a I am having x, so I'll get e power ay into a, I'll get a is x here, right? Then v as it is, e power xy as it is, derivative of u, derivative of y with respect to y is 1. So simplify this, what we'll get, here e power xy can be taken out. So what will remain here, xy plus 1. The same way, now find dou n by dou x, right? You observe that here x is there and here also x is there. Here is x, here is x. So uv rule, again we have to apply uv rule. So again we have to apply uv rule. Now u, x is as it is, right? E power xy, derivative of e power xy with respect to x is e power xy into y plus, then e power xy as it is, e power xy as it is, derivative of x with respect to x is 1 plus 2y is a constant because we are differentiating partially with respect to x, 2y is a constant, derivative of that will be 0. So what we'll get here, e power xy you take out, what will remain, xy plus 1. So therefore what we can say here, therefore dou m by dou y is equal to dou n by dou x. Therefore what we can say, therefore equation 1 is exact, equation 1 is exact. Now if it is exact, then general solution of 1 is, therefore general solution of 1 is what it is, integral y constant mdx plus integral terms of n not involving x into dy equal to constant, right? Integral y constant mdx plus integral terms of n not involving x dy equals to constant. So m is here, m is y into, see what is m here, integral y constant, so m is here, y into e power xy, that we have to write here. So y into e power xy dx plus integral terms of n not involving x, See, n is x into e power xy plus 2y. Now, in these two terms, x is not there in 2y. X is there in this term, but x is not there in 2y. So, I have to write here 2y into dy equal to constant. Now, I have to integrate. Find the integration of these two. See, in the first integral, y is treated as constant, y as it is. Then, integration of e power xy with respect to xy. So, I will get here e power xy by y. Right? Plus 2 into integration of y. Integration of y is y square by 2 with respect to y equal to constant. Here this 2 and this y will get cancelled. So general solution will be, therefore general solution will be e power xy plus y square equal to c. This will be the required general solution of given differential equation, e power xy plus y square equal to constant. Right? This is the required general solution of given exact differential equation, right? So sometimes these type of questions will be asked for 2 marks, right? Sometimes questions will be like, you will not be asked to find the general solution, or you will not be asked to solve the given exact differential equation. Just one equation will be given and you will be asked to check whether the given differential equation is exact or not, right? So in that case, what we have to do, we have to check whether the given differential equation is exact or not. Up to this only we have to solve. We don't need to find this general solution, right? We have to check whether the given differential equation is exact or not. So sometimes that kind of questions will be asked, but in general you will be given question to solve only, right? To find the general solution. So in today's class, students, we have discussed what is the meaning of first order, first degree differential equation, that is equation of the form dy by dx equals to f of x comma y, right? That we have discussed. Then after that, we have discussed variable separable method, right? Any given differential equation dy by dx equals to f of x comma y, if we are able to write, so this is the most general form of first order first degree differential equation, dy by dx equals to f of x comma y. Then variable separable method, we have seen, if we are able to write the given differential equation by separating the variables of y one side and x one side, then the general solution of this is given by integral of g of y dy equals to integral of h of x dx plus c, right? This is the procedure called, this is the method called variable separable method. Then we have seen 2 problems on this. Then we have started exact differential equation. What is the meaning of exact differential equation, right? Any equation of the form mdx plus ndy equals to 0 is said to be exact if dou m by dou y equals to dou n by dou x, partial derivative of m with respect to y and partial derivative of n with respect to x. If they are equal, then the given differential equation is said to be exact differential equation. And the general solution of that is given by integral mdx, treating y as constant, and plus integral terms of n not involving x dy equals to c. So based on this, we have seen couple of problems, right? In next class, we'll start what is the meaning of non-exact differential equations. That we are going to start in next class. So I'm going to end today's session here. See you in the next class. Thank you.